Few brands garner the respect the world over, and even fewer are fashion empires. In the case of Rey Kawakubo's Comme des Garcons, you're killing two birds with one stone, so to speak. On today's State of Japan, we do our very first brand review on a stalwart, not only in Japanese fashion, but internationally as well. This is the review of fashion giant Comme des Garcons. When street heads think about Comme des Garcons, commonly referred to as CDG, they tend to forget that the label is more than the heart shirts that were made famous by celebrities like Kanye West and Pharrell Williams. And yet this acknowledgement by these celebrities has made Comme des Garcons one of the premier fashion entities internationally. While the main line continues to be designed by Rei Kawakubo and team, mainly in Aoyama, Japan, the production spans the countries of France, Spain, and Turkey. The brand's origin started in 1969 in Tokyo as predominantly a women's line until 1978 when a men's line was introduced. Like Kawakubo's contemporary Yoji Yamamoto, whom she had a relationship at one point, she became known for her entire black silhouettes and usage of distressed fabrics. As the collections became more and more popular in the 1970s, CDG became one of the most recognizable brands in the international scene. The Comme des Garcons ethos is one of anti-fashion, or rather, one that challenges the established notions of beauty. One can see in most collections that Comme des Garcons uses a mixture of simple design and deconstruction, which comes to no surprise as founder Kawakubo was never actually trained in fashion. She is, in fact, a student of fine arts and literature. And this is probably the reason CDG continues to take an abstract approach to design, as mainline collections tend to have a deep gothic feel, something that journalists in the past have labeled as Hiroshima chic. Interestingly enough, the strength of Comme des Garcons may not come from its main line. In fact, it was Kawakubo's marriage to South African entrepreneur Adrian Joff that made CDG into the behemoth it is today. With Joff at the helm, CDG began churning out diffusion lines that allowed those less inclined to wear runway designs and those with less deep pockets to take part in the CDG brand, with diffusion labels like Black CDG and Play CDG becoming accessible to the average individual, the brand exploded. Adrian Joff also helmed the making of the Dover Street Market, a multi-branded store that sticks complementary brands to CDG alongside it, as well as up-and-coming designers. Joff, also seeing the talents of Russian designer Gosha Rubinsky, has personally undertaken the production, operations, and logistics for Gosha's brand, leading Gosha to concentrate on design. This has led to an increase of sales by 350%. Comme des Garcons has also spurred the careers of Junya Watanabe and Fumito Ganryu of Ganryu and Yosuke Aizawa of White Mountaineering, who was Junya Watanabe's apprentice. The CDG label has also inspired the work of Martin Margiela and Helmut Lang, among other designers. The company has also partnered with several fragrance entities and individuals, including music mogul and producer Pharrell Williams, for the unisex fragrance Girl. Having already countless collaborations under its belt, which include Nike, Lacoste, Levi's, Supreme, H&M, and many more, CDG has its hands tethered to all areas of fashion, be it luxury, casual, or street, which few Japanese fashion companies have the liberty of boasting. And as fashion becomes more global, CDG's star may continue to rise, as it could, quite possibly, become the most powerful high fashion company in Japan. Raking in $200 million a year also helps. If you by chance want to see the CDG flagship, one only needs to make a quick stop to Minami Aoyama in Japan to check out the pretty amazing location. And eclectic as well. So what are your thoughts on CDG? Love it? Hate it? I want to know what you think in the comments. Also, give me suggestions of brands you would like to hear about right here on the Casuals Brand Review. And don't worry, Underground Heads, this is just the beginning. We'll definitely go deeper into Japanese fashion. In any case, keep it locked right here for the latest in Japanese street fashion and culture. And if you haven't already, push that red button and keep it casual. It's your boy. Yoroshiku onegaishimasu. And I'm out.